to a lot of people, immunotherapy is a black box. And I'm going to give you a little bit of a primer on it, and you'll see that it's not actually super, super complicated. So the key is that immunotherapy treatments, be they antibodies or vaccines, are not aimed at the cancer. Virtually every drug that previously has been used in cancer therapy, all of the chemotherapy drugs, a lot of the so-called targeted therapy drugs that people have talked about, are aimed directly at the cancer cell. These immunotherapies are not at all aimed at the cancer cell. They are aimed at the patient's immune system. And the whole premise is that virtually all patients with cancer have within their own immune system the capability to recognize and kill that cancer cell. And we just have to help them out a little bit. So I think about the immune system in the sense of a car. There are two major things that you need in a car to get you from point A to point B. One is you need the gas pedal, and the other is you need the brake. And then also you need the steering wheel to show you where to go. It turns out that cancers throw on the parking brake of the immune system. And that is one of the major ways in which they resist or evade being recognized by all of those cells in the patient that can actually go after their tumor. And so once you know what those brakes are, and in some cases it's really like the parking brake thrown on, you can actually make drugs or antibodies to those molecules that have the functional effect of undoing that parking brake to the immune system. There are other ways that you activate or push the immune system, and that would be the equivalent of pushing on the accelerator. And so I like to break it into three categories, which I'm going to show you here as an example with these cars. Okay, so I'm going to put one car at the top of this hill, and then I'm going to put one car facing down the hill, and I'll hold this car facing up the hill. This represents a patient with a cancer who has a very activated immune system that is ready to go after their cancer. Oftentimes when you look in their cancer with a biopsy, you can actually see all those immune cells, those T cells actually in the cancer. All this car needs to go is to inactivate the parking brake. Now the immune system has many, many brakes. It doesn't just have one parking brake, but we discovered a number of years ago, based on a lot of research over decades in basic immunology, that in tumors, potentially the most important single parking brake is a system called PD-1. And that's a receptor on immune cells. When it's engaged, those cells get turned off. So it's like this car with the parking brakes thrown on. So in patients that are in that situation, all we have to do is put in one single antibody called anti-PD-1, and that disables the parking brake. You release the parking brake and boom, the car goes. And for the patient, that means that the immune system, with that one parking brake turned off, inactivated, will go after that cancer. That's about 20% of overall cancer patients, many, many different cancer types. In some cases, like melanoma, it's a very high proportion that you can just block that one PD-1 parking brake or inactivate it. And there are other cancers, like pancreas cancer or prostate cancer, where it takes a lot more than that. Then you have cancers that are like this car on the top of the hill. That car, if you just inactivate or release the parking brake, it's still going to, it's not going to move. It's not going to move. So you need to do something else. You need to push on that accelerator while at the same time inactivating or releasing the parking brake. Again, if you have a car like this and the parking brake is on, you push on the accelerator somewhat, the car is still not going to move much until you undo the brake. So here's a case where we start to bring in combination immunotherapies. One therapy like the anti-PD-1 that inactivates the parking brake, and another one that pushes on the accelerator. But it doesn't take much. It doesn't take much, and that car will go. And if you get a little bit of momentum, then again, that car goes on its own. Lung cancer is an example where, in some cases, all you need to do is inactivate the parking brake. But in the majority of cases, you want to do something in addition. Then you have the toughest cancers of all. These are cancers like, again, pancreas cancer, prostate cancer, where it's like a car that is facing up the hill. Not only do you have to inactivate the parking brake, but you have to really push on the accelerator. Well, one of the best ways are cancer vaccines. Cancer vaccine, when given by itself, is like pushing on the accelerator while the parking brake is thrown on full. And so now, one of the things that we're actively pursuing at Johns Hopkins, and it's being pursued elsewhere, but certainly in the Kimmel Cancer Center, we're putting a lot of focus and interest and emphasis on that, is combining cancer vaccines with antibodies that block not just one checkpoint, which is that parking brake, but that inactivate many different parking brakes on the immune system. These are the ones that you're going to have to really put the hardest effort into doing, bringing in other approaches like the immunologic effects of bone marrow transplantation, in some cases radiation therapy, together with vaccines and antibodies against these parking brakes. We foresee putting together 3 or 4 or 5 of these immunotherapies for these very toughest of cancers that are represented by this car facing up the hill, to get it up that hill and eventually down, to get that immune system to kill that patient's cancer. There's still a lot that we need to learn about the best way to push on the accelerator, and also to learn about the 5 or 10 or 15 different parking brakes that different cancers throw on the immune system. And as we learn that, this is how we put together the combinations of immunotherapy that we think can really capture literally as many as 95% of cancer patients into a clinical remission, not for just months, like oftentimes happens with chemotherapy, but literally for years and decades to come.